Joker. So those are a few characters he's kind of experimented on here. But let's go here in game one. Kalos versus Nicko. Kalos did beat on his opponent with a 2-0. So we'll see what that 2-0 leads into Nicko.
Okay. He's already got a little bit of control here. Able to navigate around the Shulk's sword, though. Nothing too bad. Ooh, and then a bit of a risky F-smash there. Could have gotten a lot more off of that falling fair, but decided to go for that. And all of a sudden, Nicko calling out all the jumps every single time that Kalos tries to come back to center stage. He's getting a lot of damage racked up because of it.
Good use of Nair. The back hit of Nair will allow Nicko to confirm and add those opportunities. Nice smash on into up tilt. The reason for that is because Kalos overshot himself, so one up tilt day will keep Wolf away.
Mm-hmm. 100% already what I'm seeing is that Kalos has got a really big jumping problem, and he's also got a really big recovering high problem.
Yep.
Because every single time, Nicko just preemptively thinking, okay, you know what, mid-level player, probably going to be jumping a lot out of disadvantage, so let's just call out the jump immediately, and then that's already a bad position to be in. A character like Wolf, not the best landing options after the jump's gone, so you gotta be really careful about that.
Yeah, and in any fighting game, jumping out of the corner is usually the demonstration of a player who's panicking, right? At this point, Kalos has lost 2 stocks already, 30% on Nico's hands. He is jumping out of disadvantage quite a lot of times. Not only that, the one thing that Wolf mains love to do is go for aerials. But the one thing that Shulk doesn't have in air-to-air is the frame data, but when he lacks in frame data, he makes up for in distance.
Yeah, nice. Again, at least he didn't just hold in while jumping. He, like, tried to mix up his landing, so kept Nicko on his toes just a little bit, but still. Let's see, another jump. Again, he's going to call that out. He's going to catch him coming back to the stage.
Yeah.
And just like that, jumping every single time out of disadvantage, another high recovery. That is exactly what I'm talking about. Nicko just called out the exact flaw in his gameplay and just exploited it to its maximum potential.
Yeah, the thing about Shulk, man, you have to imagine his range like a bubble. It is a very big bubble. And if you happen to be in that range when you're jumping, anywhere in that general range is specific, you have to be aware of that. And the fact that he's, like I said, and you even said it as well, to start it off, he's jumping out of disadvantage. He's coming in with aerials. You don't want to be over Shulk when he has up tilt. He took your first stock with up tilt. You don't think he's going to take the last one with it either? Mm-hmm.
All right, we got a quick character change with our old boy Ike. Haven't seen him in a hot minute.
We haven't seen this quote-unquote top tier in a hot minute. Nico's history with Ike has always been very, very funny. He hates Ike. He hated Ike back in Super Smash Bros. For Wii U. And SM248 can definitely tell you a thing about it too. This ain't SM248. This is going to be Nico's Joker versus this Ike here. Nice already with the up throw up air, and he's got them on the platform. Jump out of the disadvantage from the platform here. He doesn't have range, but he has the speed to contest with Ike.
And switching off to the Joker now, I know that gameplay-wise, Nico's not the biggest fan of Joker, but he loves the Persona series.
Yeah.
So that's always a tough cookie to be in. It's just, okay, I don't like how this character plays, but I love this character, so do I put up with it? So, you know, he's just going to take some time. Maybe he thought, okay, Kalos was pretty simple to try and figure out the last game, so let's see if I can do the same thing with Joker.
Yeah. And for those of you guys wondering here, this is number one seed at this tournament today. It's going to be Nicko. So Kalos trying to hold on his own. I didn't space the Nair, so no follow-up afterwards.
And already, we're seeing the Nicko kind of a similar game plan. Okay, called out the jump and the high recovery again. He's able to make it back, though. And at least Kalos is mixing it up on the ledge. He's not jump get up every single time and then trying to push his way back to the center stage. He's doing, like, neutral get ups, roll backs, different kinds of stuff.
A little bit too early on the calendar there. Definitely would have caught Kalos.
Nice conversion on the downward take aim into the forward tilt. Getting himself a pretty good situation here. Got himself Arsene. One good back air, one good aerial. Yeah, just like that, that's going to be able to take the stock.
That was a really good fake out jump because he went for the up throw. He jumped, quickly hopped back down, looking to see where Kalos is going to land. The fact that he's kind of keeping Kalos conditioned to go for these empty hops that Nico's going for pretty much allowed Kalos to play into Nico's hands.
Okay, good air dodge read though. Let's see if he can try and keep him at the ledge. Nope, tried to press too many buttons, and Joker's a little bit too fast for that after the neutral get up. You got to be careful about that.
Yeah, and he didn't fast fall the up air, which you could have gotten a re-grab from that at that percent.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. Nice him taking down, bring Kalos down with him as well. Oh, and he definitely waited for the counter on that one.
Yeah, try to catch him on the high recovery again. Oh, and there we go. Arsene is back. Got a little bit too greedy, trying to take advantage. And another back air going to seal it out. Looking like a potential 3-stock with the Joker as well, but I like that. Waiting on the Angel platform, going to try and wait out Arsene just a little bit.
Yeah, it is a very viable tactic here. If you have the Angel platform when you're coming on the recovery here, wait out Arsene for just a second. A lot of players like to come in really quick, right? You have kinda, it's a risk-reward factor. Do I wait for the guaranteed Arsene to go down, or do I try to come down with invincibility and combo my opponent so that the Rebel's guard meter actually goes lower, faster?
Yeah. I think what I'm seeing with Kalos as well, he doesn't either know when he's going to hit confirm into another conversion off of aerial, or off of neutral aerial, or he doesn't know the exact percentages of like which conversion you can get after neutral air. Because you'll see him, he'll press a button afterwards, he'll either do like a forward tilt or like a roll, or he'll wait like that and see, because maybe he's not sure, he's not confident that he's going to land in neutral air. And that's something you got to do. It's like, okay, I hit an air, now I can finally get something like that. Yes, gets the conversion there. But other times you can see he's doing it on shield. He's not confident that he's going to be able to either get him to drop shield or to coincide with something else.
And that's why you want to implement empty hopping in your game plan, too. We saw Nicko do that, especially at several points of the game. Not only that, empty hopping is really good. Understanding the spacing in which going for things like Nair and Fair on the shield are really worth going for. Because if you don't space it, you will get a punish like so.
Mm-hmm. Up smash, even with a parry, you do have a 3-fame advantage, but still a little too slow to be able to get anything off of it. So that's just a free forward smash, and Nico's going to be moving on in the bracket.
He's like, yo, man, I really destroyed this character, man. I'm so sorry. That's how you knew Nicko won. He unplugged the joystick way faster than his opponent. He's like, I'm out.